raised in Pakistan. How Shams Qureshi is recognized and remembered in subcontinent, especially in Pakistan, this is an interesting research. It has two opposite trajectories. One consists of people who are initiated in the field, where does the other comprise the common people? The former category view Shams as he is projected in Maulana poetry and historical books like Manaqib-ul Arifin by Akhlaqi and Nafhatul Uns by Jami, etc. Well-known and sound poets have written poetry in his admiration. They have simply used his name as a symbol of love. The latter category have created several fictions about him and considered Shams Tabrizi everyone who went by the name of Shamsuddin in history. There is an ancient tomb in Multan, Pakistan. The attendant of this tomb is known as Shams-e-Tabrizi, in common person, who was the mentor of Maulana. But it is absolutely wrong. It is said that his real epithet was Tabriz, in heat giving, which disfigured into Tabriz. The one whose tomb is in Multan is Shamsuddin, originally from Sabzewar, Iran, and was the descendant of Ismail, son of Imam Jafar Sadat. His father, Salahuddin Muhammad Nurbash, belonged to Ismail sect. We can briefly describe Shamsuddin Sabzewari of Multan, as he was born in Sabzewar, Iran. In 1165, he arrived in Kashmir with his father and returned to Sabzewar in 1189, and went to Tabriz in 600 after Hijra, and stayed there in meditation for 12 years. Where he came out of meditation, he went to Konya and then traveled to Egypt and Syria, and went back to Sabzewar after touring these areas. His father died in 664. Following his father's death, he went to Baghdad. The clerics of Baghdad declared him infidel and were bent upon to tear apart his skin. He miraculously put on a blanket and tears apart his own skin, which was demonstrated to the whole city. He took back his skin in evening and wore it like dress. Then he attended to travel to India. He reached Multan in 665. He died there in about 675. His first tomb was constructed in 677. Present tomb was constructed almost 350 years ago back. Now the administration of this shrine is totally in hand of Shia community of Multan. Here is some pictures of that shrine of Shams Tabrizi. This is a wall. This is the tomb of Shams Tabriz in Multan. This is another view. This is the Qatba. This is the Chiragh Candle Palace of Shams Tabriz from in Multan. This is Darvish. They are sitting there. This is the inside of the tomb. This is also inside of the crypt. This is the old window of Shams Tabriz. This is the information board about Shams Tabriz. As a shajara also. mention another Shamsuddin Tabrizi in India. He was a disciple of Sheikh Muhammad Ghaus and he wrote many footnotes in Hawashi on his mentor's book. He died in 994. We have very little literature about Shams Tabrizi in Urdu language. Mostly the books written about Maulana Jalaluddin also discuss Shams like Shibli Nomani's book Samanya Maulana Rum. In his book, he mainly used Aflaki's Manakul Arfin and Jami's Nafhar. The first book written in Urdu focusing on Shams Tabrizi is by Muhammaddin Fogg, published in 1910, 100 years ago. Another book written by Peer Ghulam Dastagir Nami of Lahore entitled Sawane Hayat Hazrat Shams Tabriz, published in 1960. He wrote his book with reference to Aflaki, Jami, and Sipah Salar Risala and Shibli Nomani research. In the last chapter of the book, he mentioned the contradict about Shams Tabrizi and Shams Sabzewari of Multan. With reference to some research scholars, he mentioned that Shams of Multan was native of Tardis, a village near Sabzewar.